الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين كنا في الحصة الماضية ذكرنا أن الإسلام هو دين كل الأنبياء. In the previous session we mentioned that Islam is the religion of all the prophets. وقلنا بأن أول الأنبياء هو آدم عليه السلام. We mentioned that the first prophet was Adam عليه السلام. لكن لم يكن هناك كفار بين البشر في زمانه. But there was no blasphemers among the human beings during his time. بعد آدم جاء شيث ثم إدريس. After Adam, Prophet Shith came, then إدريس. بعد وفاة إدريس حصل الكفر أول ما حصل بين الناس. After the death of Prophet Idris, blasphemy started to appear among the people. ثم بعد وفاة إدريس بألف سنة نزل الوحي على سيدنا نوح. 1,000 years after the death of Prophet Idris, revelation came down on Prophet Nuh, Noah. فَكَانَ نُوحَ أَوَّلَ رَسُولٍ أُرْسِلَ إِلَىٰ قَوْمٍ كُفَّارٍ. Prophet Nuh was the first prophet sent to blasphemous people. هذه المدة بين إدريس ونوح هي الجاهلية الأولى المذكورة في القرآن. This period between Idris and Nuh is al-jahiliyya al-ula, the first era of ignorance mentioned in al-Qur'an. بعد نوح تتابع الرسل. After Prophet Nuh, there were many prophets. إلى عيسى عليه السلام. Up till Prophet Jesus. بعدما رفع عيسى عليه السلام لم يبعث نبي إلى سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فليس بينهما نبي. After Prophet Isa was raised to heaven, no prophet was sent until Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. المدة ما بين رفع عيسى وبعثة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام أكثر من 500 عام. The period between the raise of Prophet Isa, between Prophet Isa, when Prophet Isa was raised to the sky, and the revelation of Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام was more than 500 years. And there were no prophets between these two, Isa and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وكان آخر الأنبياء محمدا عليه الصلاة والسلام. The last prophet was Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. هؤلاء الأنبياء دينهم كلهم كان واحدا هو الإسلام. These prophets had one religion, all of them, which is Islam. لكن شرائعهم اختلفت, but there were differences between the set of laws revealed to them. شريعة التوراة فيها شيء مختلف عن شريعة يعقوب عليه السلام, وشريعة عيسى فيها بعض الأمور مختلفة عن شريعة التوراة. وشريعة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام فيها أمور تختلف عن شريعة عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. For example, the rules of Torah revealed to Prophet Musa عليه السلام differed in certain issues from the rules revealed to Prophet Jacob. And the set of rules revealed to Prophet Isa differed in certain issues from what was revealed to Prophet Musa. Likewise, what was revealed to Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام differed in certain issues from what was revealed to Prophet Isa. لكن كلهم كانوا على دين واحد وهو الإسلام. But all of them followed the same belief, the same religion of Islam. وقد علم الله تعالى أن مصالح العباد مصلحة العباد لا تقتضي تغير الأحكام التي أنزلت على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فلذلك كانت الشريعة المحمدية خاتمة الشرائع فلا يكون بعدها شريعة أخرى. Allah Ta'ala knew with His eternal knowledge that people do not need any change in the set of rules revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until the day of judgment. This is why there would be no prophet that would come after Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam with a new set of rules. Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam خاتم الأنبياء وشريعته خاتمة الشرائع. Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام is the last prophet and the set of rules revealed to him is the last revealed set of rules. وعندما أرسل سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام عندما نزل عليه الوحي لم يكن بين الناس في ذلك الوقت مسلم غيره. When Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام received the revelation, among the people there were no other Muslim, no Muslim other than him. سيدنا عيسى في السماء كان. Prophet Isa was in the sky. He is still in heaven. وسيدنا الخضر أغلب وقته على الماء. And Prophet Al-Khadir spends most of the time on the water, not on land. إِنَّمَا يَأْتِي إِلَى هَذَا الرَّجُلِ الصَّالِحِ يُرْشِدُهُ إِلَى أَمَرٍ وَإِلَى ذَاكَ يُرْشِدُهُ إِلَى أَمَرٍ وَإِلَى ذَاكَ يُرْشِدُهُ إِلَى أَمَرٍ وفي ذلك الوقت ما كان بين البشر صالحون بل ولا مؤمنون. الخضر عليه السلام spends most of his time on water and not on land. He comes to this pious person, to one pious person and advises him with things, then to another person, a third person, and so on. But at the time of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, there were no pious people other than him among the people. There were no believers among the people other than the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. So Al-Khadir was not in contact with the people at that time. لذلك قلنا كان النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أول المسلمين في زمانه بين الناس. This is why we say that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was the first among the Muslims during his time. The first Muslim during that time. That is, there were no other Muslim among the people. No one other than him living among the people. ولذلك قال ربنا تبارك وتعالى قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين وبذلك أمرت وأنا وحده لا شريك له وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين. أمره الله أن يقول إنه أول المسلمين أي في زمانه. This is why Allah Ta'ala in Al-Quran ordered Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say that he was the first Muslim, that is during his time. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وقد أيده الله تعالى بالمعجزات الدالة على نبوته. Allah تبارك وتعالى supported Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with miracles. Am I going fast? Yeah. No. Okay. Allah تعالى supported Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with miracles that showed his truthfulness. فدخل بعض الناس ممن بلغتهم دعوته في الإسلام. A part among the people among whom they heard his call, a part of them embraced al-Islam. قسم من هؤلاء كانوا في الأصل من عبدة الأصنام. A part of these people who embraced al-Islam were originally idol worshippers. وقسم كانوا من النصارى واليهود. Another part were either Christians or Jew. ومنهم من كان إنسيا ومنهم من كان جنيا. Some of them were human beings and some were among the jinn who followed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ومنهم ومن الجن الذين تبعوه من كان حيا من أيام عيسى عليه السلام. Among the jinn who followed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there were ones who were still alive since the time of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. وذلك لأن الجنة تطول أعمارهم في العادة. كثير منهم تطول أعمارهم. This is because a lot among the jinn live for a long time. مئات السنين وأكثر. They live hundreds of years. كان رجل يقال له الجعد بن قيس المرادي. A man called الجعد بن قيس from the tribe of Murad, من أهل اليمن, among the inhabitants of اليمن. كان مسافرا. He was traveling. ثم سمع في الليل نزل في مكان ليستريح. He stopped at a place to have a rest at night. سمع صوت جني يكلمه هو والذين معه. He heard the voice of a jinni, one among the jinn, who addressed him and the people traveling with him. بأبيات من الشعر, He was saying verses of poetry, this jinn. يذكر فيها النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, in which he mentions the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. ويقول بأن سيدنا عيسى أوصاهم باتباعه. And he says that Prophet, and he said that Prophet Isa عليه السلام told them to follow Prophet Muhammad when he appears, صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا الرجل ما كان سمع بعد عن بعثة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. This man, الجعد ابن قيس, الجعد the son of قيس, did not hear at the time about the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. فلما ذهب إلى مكة سأل عنه. So when he arrived to Mecca, he asked about the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثم لقيه فأسلم. Then he met the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and he embraced الإسلام. كان إسلامه بسبب هذا الجني. He embraced الإسلام because of this Muslim among the jinn. الذي كان أدرك عاش من أيام سيدنا عيسى إلى سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, who lived from the time of Prophet Isa until the time of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقسم من الناس جحدوا بنبوته. The other part of those who heard his call rejected what he said, what the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said. ومنهم من كان مشركا قبل هذا كان مشركا. Some of them before rejecting the call of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام worshipped other than Allah عز وجل. كفرقة من اليهود كانوا يعبدون عزيرا. Like a group among the Jews who used to worship Uzair, a pious person called Uzair. كانوا يقولون هو ابن الله. They used to say he is the son of God. في الزمن الماضي في وقت من الأوقات فقدت نسخ التوراة كلها. At one point of time, all the copies of the Torah were destroyed. ما بقيت ولو نسخة واحدة بين أيدي الناس. Not even one copy remained among the people. فعزير ألقى التوراة من حفظه. كتبوا التوراة من حفظه. At that time, Uzair, this pious man, he recited the whole Torah by heart. So they wrote it from him. وفي الأمم السابقة ما كانوا معتادين عن يحفظوا كتبهم. ما كانوا يحفظون كتبهم. ما كانت عادتهم حفظ كتبهم. In the previous nations, it wasn't their habit to memorize the books revealed to their prophets. They didn't memorize the books revealed to their prophets. ليس مثل هذه الأمة. Not like this nation. في الأمة المحمدية ابن سبع سنين يقرأ القرآن كله عن ظهر قلب. Sometimes in these nations you would find a 7-year-old child that would recite the whole Quran by heart. هذا ما كان في الأمم السابقة مثله. This didn't exist in the previous nations. ف فلما ألقى التوراة من حفظه تعجبوا. So when he recited the whole Torah by heart, they were astonished. ثم قالوا عنه هو ابن الله. And so some of them said, he is the son of God. لولا أنه ابن الله كيف يلقي التوراة من حفظه. They said, hadn't him not been the son of God, how could have he memorized the whole Torah? هؤلاء كانوا موجودين. This group existed at the time. Of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. وكانوا مشركين كما هو ظاهر. So they worshipped with Allah. They worshipped Uzair. They took partners with Allah تبارك وتعالى. ثم لما جاء سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام رفضوه ولم يؤمنوا برسالته فازدادوا كفرا. When Prophet Isa عليه السلام called them, got the revelation, they refused to believe in him. So they committed an extra blasphemy by that. ثم عندما ظهر محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام كفروا به فازدادوا كفرا. Then again, when Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام called to Islam and got the revelation, their blasphemy increased because they refused to believe in him. وبعض اليهود والنصارى كما قلنا آمنوا بالنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. Now some people among the Jews and the Christians believed in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. مثل عبد الله بن سلام عالم اليهود في المدينة. Like عبد الله بن سلام, who was the most knowledgeable person among the Jews in Al-Madinah. جاء إلى النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام فقال له أسألك عن أمور ثلاثة. He came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and he told him, I want to ask you three questions. أي كان يعرف عبد الله أن العرب لا يعرفون أجوبتها. And this man knew that the Arabs didn't know the answers of these questions. فسأله عما أراد. He asked him these questions. فأجابه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عنها. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام gave him the correct answers. وقال له أخبرني بهن جبريل آنفا. And the Prophet told him that Jibril, Angel Jibril, came to him and told him the answers of these questions. فأسلم عبد الله بن سلام. عبد الله بن سلام embraced Islam then. وتشهد. He took الشهادة. وكان هو ممن بشرهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالجنة من غير العشرة الذين بشروا في حديث واحد. And he was among the people who got the good news of entering paradise from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Among other than the 10 companions who got the good news in one hadith, there are other than them. Among them was this person, Abdullah ibn Salam, radiyallahu anhu. بعدما أسلم كان بعد عند النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام عندما جاءه بعض اليهود. After he embraced Al-Islam, he was still at the place of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, where the Prophet was, when some Jews came to talk to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فدخل عبد الله بن سلام إلى مكان لا يرونه فيه. Abdullah ibn Salam moved to a place where they cannot see him. فلما دخلوا قال لهم النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ماذا تقولون في عبد الله بن سلام. When they came in, the Prophet asked them, what do you say about Abdullah ibn Salam? قالوا خيرنا وابن خيرنا سيدنا وابن سيدنا وعالمنا وابن عالمنا. They said, he is our master and the son of our master, the most knowledgeable among us and the son of the most knowledgeable among us. فقال فإن أسلم أرأيتم إن أسلم. The Prophet told them, what do you think if he embraced Al-Islam? قالوا أعاذه الله من ذلك. They said, may Allah protect him from that. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام فإنه قد أسلم. So the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام told them, he already embraced Al-Islam. قالوا أعاذه الله من ذلك. They didn't believe. They said, may Allah protect him from that. فخرج إليهم عبد الله بن سلام ونطق بالشهادتين أمامه. Abdullah ibn Salam appeared and he uttered the testification of faith in front of them. فَقَالُوا شَرُّنَا وَابْنُ شَرِّنَا وَجَاهِلُنَا وَابْنُ جَاهِلِنَا. So they said, well, this is the worst person among us and the son of the worst person, and the most ignorant among us and the son of the most ignorant person among us. فقال ابن سلام للنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ألم أقل لك يا رسول الله إنهم قوم بهت. معناه يكابرون يعاندون لا يسلمون بالحق. وكذلك كان ممن آمن به عليه الصلاة والسلام أصحمة النجاشي. Also among those who believed in the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام was أصحم النجاشي, ملك الحبشة, the king of Abyssinia. النجاشي لقب لكل من يملك تلك البلاد, يقال له النجاشي. Each one, everyone that governs that area is called النجاشي. أما اسمه فكان أصحم. As for his name, it was أصحم. أهل الحبشة كثير منهم يقولون أحمد النجاشي, وهذا غلط. A lot among the people of Ethiopia, Abyssinia, they say that his name was Ahmed. They say Ahmed al-Najashi about him. And this is wrong. His name was not Ahmed. His name was Ashama. كان أولا نصرانيا. First he was a Christian. ثم عندما هاجر بعض الصحابة إلى الحبشة كان من بينهم جعفر بن أبي طالب أخو سيدنا علي. When some of the companions emigrated to Abyssinia, among them was جعفر, the son of Abu Talib, the brother of Al-Imam Ali. النجاشي كان سمح لهؤلاء المهاجرين بالإقامة في بلاده. النجاشي gave permission to this companion, to this immigrant, to stay in his land. كفار قريش أرسلوا من يحرضه عليهم. The blasphemers in Mecca sent people to try to instigate an-Najashi against them. فاستدعاهم النجاشي يقول لهم ماذا تقولون؟ ما هو اعتقادكم؟ النجاشي called them and asked them, what is your belief? فتكلم من بينهم, اتفقوا أن يتكلم من بينهم سيدنا جعفر. They agreed that Ja'far ibn Abi Talib would be the one who addresses the king. فتكلم جعفر فبين عقيدة الإسلام التي جاء بها النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. Ja'far talked and he explained the belief of Islam with which the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام came. فظهر من كلام النجاشي وحاله القبول. When Ja'far talked, it appeared on النجاشي that he was accepting what was mentioned. فقال له بعض كفار قريش هؤلاء يقولون في المسيح غير ما تقول. One of the blasphemers, one of the people sent by the blasphemers of Mecca told him, these people, they have a different creed about Jesus than yours. فقال ماذا تقولون فيه. So he asked Ja'far, what do you say about Jesus? فشرح له جعفر عقيدة الإسلام في عيسى. Ja'far told him what the Muslims say about Prophet Isa. فحلف النجاشي عند ذلك أن عيسى أن حال عيسى هو كما يقول جعفر على التمام. So at this moment, النجاشي swore by Allah that what Ja'far said was the truth about عيسى عليه السلام. ثم إنه دخل في الإسلام. Then he embraced الإسلام. بعد ذلك وبسببه أسلم بعض الرهبان الذين كانوا عنده. And because of him, some priests or monks embraced Islam. وأرسل ولده وذهبوا وفدا إلى النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. And they went, a delegation of them went to the Prophet. They met with the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. وأرسل ولده أيضا إلى النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. And he sent his son to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. لكن ما استطاع النجاشي أن ينشر الإسلام على الوجه الذي أحب وأراد. But he could not spread Islam the way he wished to do. لأنه طلع له من وقف ضده من أهل البلد. Because then among the people of Abyssinia, some people stood against him. حتى إنهم حاربوه. And they attacked him, they launched war against him. لكنه غلبهم بإذن الله. But he defeated them. لكنه انشغل بهذا عن نشر الدين. But with this he was occupied from spreading the religion. ثم مات. Then he died. يوم موته أوحي إلى النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بذلك. When he died, at the same day, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام got the revelation that النجاشي died. فقال للصحابة مات اليوم أخوكم أصحم وهو رجل صالح. He told the companions, today your brother أصحم died and he was a pious person. ثم صلى عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صلاة الغائب. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام prayed for him the funeral prayer although he was absent away from him. وكان بعد موته يظهر نور على قبره في الليل. يرى نور على قبره. After his death, people used to see light on top of his grave at night. السيدة عائشة قالت كنا نتحدث أنه لا يزال يظهر على قبره النور. السيدة عائشة said that it was known among us that the light appeared on top of the grave of النجاشي at night. وقبره إلى الآن معروف. His grave is known up till now في شمال إثيوبيا, in northern Ethiopia. من مدة 40 سنة. وحيث هو مدفون بقربه بعض الصحابة أيضا. And where he is buried, there are some of the companions, several companions buried there. من نحو 40 سنة أو 50 سنة ما كان المقام مبنيا ب كان مبنيا بالمسقوفا بال كيف نقوله بالتنك. Before 40 years or so, the building that was built on his grave, the top or the ceiling was made of, what do you call this? Metal sheets. Yes. Okay. Huh? Okay. Sheet metal, okay. And one time some of the blasphemers who were there wanted to make harm to the servant of that place. بعض الكفار أراد أن يؤذي خادم المقام. فطار لوح من هذه الألواح فقطع رأس هذا الكافر ورجع إلى مكانه. One sheet among these sheets moved and flew, cut the head of this blasphemer and went again to its place. بعد هذا ما عادوا يحاولون إذاء أحد هناك. Since then, they don't make harm to anyone who's there. أما الآن مبني من البطون والحجر. Now it's built of cement. It's no more like that. الله. وهذا أي ما قاله النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام وذكرته السيدة عائشة يدل على أنه صار من أولياء الله تعالى قبل موته. And what the Prophet said and سيدة عائشة said shows that النجاشي became a wali before his death. رضي الله عنه. والمبدأ يعني الأساس الجامع لكل أهل الإسلام من أمة سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام والأمم السابقة عبادة الله وحده. The principle which is common between all the Muslims, whether they are from this nation or from the previous nations, is to worship Allah تبارك وتعالى without any partner. ولا بد مع ذلك أن يؤمن كل منهم بنبي زمانه. Of course, each one of them has to believe in the Prophet of his era, of his time. صلى الله عليه وسلم. طيب نكتفي بهذا. Let us stop here. والله أعلم. الله knows best. أحد عنده سؤال؟ Do you have any questions? نعم. صدقت. ما ترجمت؟ أنت تعرف. فهمت. أي تفضل. خلونا نسمع يا أخواننا. خلونا نسمع. Please let. I know you are far away in the back, but I think if you talk, then you are not going to hear neither the questions nor the answers. نعم الهجرة كانت مرتين إلى الحبشة. Yes, the Muslims emigrated twice to Abyssinia before going back to Al-Madinah. Yes. نعم تفضلي داوية. Go ahead. Yes, the true Torah. The true Torah existed until, يعني, even at the time of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, it still existed. Yes. Among the Jews, there were people who still knew things, many things from the prophets, from the prophets who came before. And Abdullah ibn Salam was among these people. So yes, he had a lot of knowledge. To believe in Prophet Isa and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Basically, this was it. And to follow the rules of Prophet Muhammad. Because at the time, they didn't... The true Torah still existed and he had it. He was among the people who had the true Torah. وَبِكُمْ One of them, his father told him, before he died, his father had books, and he told him, don't read in this book. He had one, in one of his books, he had the papers, glued together. So like as if he had like these papers like this glued from here together. And he told him, don't open these papers to check what's there. After his father died, this man was curious. So he couldn't resist it. He opened these papers. This was at the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab, during his caliphate. So he opened the papers, and in there he read all the description of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. So he embraced al-Islam. And then he became later among the scholars, the big scholars, who learned from the companions. So they had still, at the time, they still knew things that the prophets who came before talked about. But it wasn't widespread. Yeah, not so many of them. And some, before Prophet Muhammad got the revelation, the Jews used to tell the other people living in the Arabic peninsula, now it's the time for a prophet to appear. When he will appear, you'll see what we will do. That is, they were threatening them. We will attack you with this prophet. We will do this and this to you. Subhanallah, they used to say this to the people of Al-Madinah. When Prophet Muhammad appeared, they didn't believe in him. And the other people whom they threatened them, they believed in Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Subhanallah, Allah yaf'alu ma yasha. Faddal Hassan. Naam. خلينا بس نشوف بالموضوع هذا بس يخلص الأسئلة تكرم عينك تفضل يا حاج هو أليس هو أليس هاجر المسلمون وآمن هو وأناس غيره من أهل البلد لكن الانتشار الكبير بعد هذا كان ليس في ذلك الزمن لا قبله ما كان كانت قبل ذلك ما كان يوجد مسلم هناك وبكم عبد الله بن سلام الآخر وهب ابن منبه أو كعب الأحبار نسيت أحدهما إما كعب الأحبار وإما وهب ابن منبه أحدهما من بعد نوح يا أيها الركب المعرس بلغوا لا بلغوا إذا يا أيها الركب المعرس بلغوا إذا ما نزلتم بالحطيم وزمزما محمدا المبعوث منا تحية تشيعه حيث سار ويمما وقولوا له إنا لدينك شيعة بذاك أوصانا المسيح ابن مريم هذه هي الأبيات اكتبها لك بعد هذا ان شاء الله طيب اتفضل يا حسن في اللحظة التي تزيد يكتب عليه كبيرة ما خلص ما هي صارت عليه هذه الكبيرة التي هي أنه تهاون إلى أن زادت معاصيه على أعماله الحسنة. ما هو واقع في الكبيرة واقع إلى هنا، واقع في الكبيرة واقع، الله يسلمنا. طيب بارك الله فيكم، نهلل. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد.